LA. Is you there?
I'm here. What's going on, brother?
How you doing?
I'm all right, man. I'm over here at my gym this morning trying to get a little workout in, but I can't do that because obviously all this coaching stuff is going crazy.
Yeah, I mean
they're very selfish. That all these coaches are trying to get jobs.
Yeah.
Teams are trying to tell, well, I'm trying to get my work at it. I mean, they're selfish. They don't care about my comp.
Glaze, I think this is the true story. I saw it on a ticker somewhere else, though. You know. You know where I'm going with that one, Glaze. We'll just
I certainly do, yeah.
What can you tell? Which one do you think is going to pop first? Give me one that you crystal ball it for me. Which one do you think is going to go first in terms of being filled?
You know what? Here's what happens. Just like anything else in life, once somebody else wants to dance with your prom date, then so does everybody else. You know what I mean? And the moment one of these things happens, the rest of them will start falling in place. They're going to go, oh, no, we're not going to get stuck with the ugliest girl sitting at the end of the bench. No way. And, you know, they're still interviewing. I mean, look, Rex Ryan's going in today for an interview with the Atlanta Falcons. You know, the Bears are still trying to do their thing. You know, I think you kind of got to look at it and go first to worst. I think when you look at a head coaching prospects, you got to say to yourself, all right, who has a quarterback? Well, we know San Francisco has a quarterback. Who doesn't? We know the Jets don't have a quarterback. We know the Bills don't have a quarterback, right? We certainly don't know about the Chicago Bears.
Right.
The Atlanta Falcons certainly have a quarterback. And then you also have to look at structure and ownership. And look, the Raiders have a quarterback. Well, you know the Raiders, you know, they've had other things that are a mess. The Jets are a mess from top to bottom. Atlanta, they're not, right? They have an owner who doesn't meddle. San Francisco 49ers, they have a good general manager in there who's set them up with all these draft picks and has done a very good job personnel-wise. So you're looking for stability upstairs, you're looking for a good quarterback, and you're looking for somebody who's not going to bring in drama. That's why I got to be honest with you. I know people are talking about Mike Shanahan, but everywhere he's gone, there's been drama. I'd rather have a guy that there is no drama. There's no subterfuge. He's just going to go in there and be a damn ball coach.
What about Glaze, somebody who's opted out of their contract, like Doug Marrone? I mean, now I don't know where to stand on that. That was something that happened on New Year's Eve that was sort of a surprising. That, you know, where why not exact to take a $4 million payday if you can't get security where you are to try and shop for a longer-term deal somewhere else? Or if you're trying to hire somebody, you just saw somebody who left a team on New Year's Eve. Where do you stand on that subject, Glaze?
Well, I think it's, you know, a guy like that is really how you decide you're going to interpret it. What I mean by that is there's a lot of candidates who these GMs and owners, they'll fall in love with. And even when they have warts, they'll convince themselves it's not a wart, it's a beauty mark. And, you know, it's the same thing with Doug. You know, Doug's a very fiery guy, incredibly fiery. Me and John Fox one year had to prevent him from beating up a damn team executive at the Senior Bowl one time, all the way back when he was a line coach. He was just a fiery dude. You look at it and go, I like that fire. I love a guy who's fiery like that. And the other end, you look at it and go, man, this guy could just fly off the handle, and he could do that, or he could just take money and bolt on everybody, and it's how you look at it. You know, Doug is a fiery guy. He's not going to be for everybody, but some people are going to be in love with him. And you look at some of the other candidates out there. I thought, personally, Rex did a phenomenal job this year, despite their record last couple of years, because we all know the hand that he was dealt. And I think early on in his career, part of it was Rex trying to be this larger-than-life character, just, you know, build his brand, and he grew up from that. You know, he kind of self-educated, and you know what? I don't need to do that. But I love guys like Dan Quinn, who, you look at a guy like Dan Quinn, and you say to yourself, if I hire Dan Quinn, I think everybody in that building will go, I cannot wait to go to work every day. That's what I mean about not having drama. I can't wait. And one thing we know about Dan Quinn is the guy develops pass rushes. Man, does he develop pass rushes. But you'll get in there and a guy who, you know, I think all these guys, you know, they are, Rich, you've been around these guys forever. Most of them change when they get the head coaching job. The good ones change back to who they really are fast. The guys who don't change back, man, these are the most street smart dudes on the planet. They'll see through you in 2 seconds. If you try and be a mini Belichick, or you try and be Andy Reid, or you try and be somebody else, they're going to see through you in 2 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why, like I said, some of these other assistants that I would look at, in the line of the Dan Quinn. I happen to like Terrell Austin a lot. I think, Detroit, their big problem last year in the past is it was okay to mess up. It was okay to get 15-yard penalties. It's okay to be disciplined. This year it wasn't. Look what they did.
Hey, Glaze. Glaze of Fox Sports, Jay Glazer, Fox Sports and Fox Sports Radio. I have about 3 minutes left in a hard out, and I want to get to one more topic with you, and that's the loss of our friend Stu, Stuart Scott.
No, man, don't make me cry again, Eric.
Well,
are you serious?
Well, here's the deal, Jay. You know, I mean, obviously, it's everybody looks at what he's did and what he's done, and it's an ESPN thing. It's really a sports business thing. You trained with him. He was training with you while he was sick. And I really want to give you the floor and talk about Stu.
Yeah, he came to me many, many, many years ago in his early stages with cancer. And, he wanted to train MMA. He had a couple lessons up in Connecticut, and he wanted to train with me because he wanted to do something that was going to, counteract how much the chemo and radiation were going to, attack his body. And the very first day, we clicked, obviously. And there's certainly a rivalry between me and ESPN, but there was nothing but love between me and Stuart Scott. See, you're doing it to me.
Yeah, I know.
You're getting me here. And this year when I was sick and I had my issue, he texted me telling me that I inspire him. Like, are you kidding me, dude? This guy was the most selfless dude I have met in this business, and I'm telling you, people die, and I truly believe in God and heaven, and I think you go to a better place. I don't cry when people pass on. It's part of life. And I have not cried since I lost my friend in 9/11 until Stuart.
And it's interesting how
it was a tough one because he fought so hard. You're going, he's just going to win this.
Yeah, I know. I thought the same thing.
40 years. Not going to lose.
I thought
he didn't lose.
I know. I thought he was going to beat it, too.
He didn't tap out.
I know. And Glaze, it's interesting you say call him selfless. It's that his on-air style so many people thought was a look-at-me type style, but he couldn't be more selfless. That's a perfect way to describe
it. You know what? Everybody who used to rip him and make fun and poke and all that, screw all you people. This guy was about as genuine and cool as a human being you'll ever meet in this business. He never was like, look at me. He was always like, what can I do for you? And he was, he transcended ESPN versus anybody. So he is, I do know that we will keep training together, me and him. And hey, just because I think we just rent these bodies, man, but the soul lives on forever. So I know he and I are going to just keep training.
Glaze, I love you, bud. You take care of yourself, okay? You bet. That's Jay Glazer of Fox Sports and Fox Sports Radio.
The Rich Eisen Show, weekdays at noon Eastern. On Audience.